We've got to protect our phony baloney job, gentlemen. We must do something about this immediately.
Well, this is the last job that Diamond City wants me to do. Clear the Massachusetts Turnpike. Might as well get to it. Okay, I heard that. Actually, let's play this a little smarter, shall we? Can I get up here? Doesn't look like. Stop looking at my pit buck. There's nothing there that's going to be a help. Okay. Here we go. Now, where are we? There's one. Need to switch this up. No, wrong weapon for this job. There we are. Come on, boys and girls. There you are. Of course he would drop at that moment. Such a waste of ammo. I really need to up my game. Was that really the only one out there? There's no such thing as one ghoul. That glow over there. Oh, very nice. I think today might include a bonus. And while we're at it, why don't I let the storyteller give me information on the ghouls I probably have? At least something to listen to while I'm waiting, while I'm doing stuff.
Ghouls already lead a hard life in the wasteland, beset by prejudice from all sides. As if that wasn't enough, they can become feral, degenerating into a wild animal kept alive by radiation, interested only in slaughter and gorging itself on whatever it manages to kill. It's a fate worse than death. Why ghouls go feral is still not entirely understood. You'd think that after 2 centuries, we would know what causes it, so we could come up with a solution. Our best guess is that exposure to intense levels of ionizing radiation or other environmental factors cause a rapid degeneration of higher brain functions and regression into a primal feral state. Feral ghouls typically cluster in groups and attack whatever disturbs them, uttering a screech that lures other ghouls that will attack in turn. With the central nervous system atrophied, feral ghouls are not bound by human limiters on muscle use, making their strikes far more deadly. The process of ghoulification is sadly irreversible, and since they don't die out like humans do, feral ghoul populations have been a plague on the wasteland for centuries, from Necropolis to Boston. Social isolation seems to be a factor in causing a ghoul to go feral, although it's anyone's guess just how impactful it can be, as communities of ghouls are also known to suffer from their members going feral.
Well, looks like there were some victims after all. I could really use this some right away. Haven't seen that in a while. lots of ghouls, though, all the way up to here. I'm sure I can put this to good use in my own home. He had a nice little setup here, didn't he? Even liked to bowl. This is a little sad. Nice place all set up like this, and then the next day, it's all flooded under by a bunch of crazy dead people. Wonder if they even knew that they were dead. Wonder if it was just this one guy against all of them. Well, buddy, that was a pretty good show if that was the case. There's any more of them back that way. And there's almost sure to be more of them in this way. So, time to get to work. But before I do, clearing the outside calls for a smoke. Nice to not have to worry about a supply of these things, at least for now. Whole spare boxes at home. Can't remember the last time I had this many cigars available. Fully kitted. And yeah, plenty of ammo for this thing. Too bad I had to leave Sparkle behind, but this really does call for a little finesse, a little bit of stealth, and she is no good at that. Alright. Let's see what we have going here. Always when you're reloading that they charge in, isn't it? Isn't that always the way? What do we got here? Hell. Privacy. Looks like somebody had this set up as a clinic. Hmm. teddy bears. Probably, probably for children. Because there's no way you're going to get a grown adult lying down on that thing. Alright. Back down to business. He was behind the eight ball. And that's a terrible joke. Thought I saw something down there. Deal with that later. Always make sure to clear your areas. You never know what you'll run into. Such as this guy. Come on, buddy. Seriously. Did he eat like 15 bullets and run away? Come on, pal. No point in standing here. Actually, proper weapon for the proper job. Oh, there's somebody. Hello, friend. People become bullet sponges. If I wind up blowing through too much ammo, this is not going to be a profitable run. Not unless there's some kind of major payoff down here. You can never count on that. Okay, I definitely heard that. How am I set for grenades? Two. Nope. Is it even worth a grenade? Lovely. Reload. Come on, you bastard. Come on. Come has to be the big bad bastard that they were thinking of. Anything else up here? No such luck. Well, if the area is clear, I might as well go ahead and see what I can pick out of it. At least I'm not picking up too much radiation in this mess. Although, thought I heard somebody back here. Yeah, I can. There we are. Still hear somebody sloshing around that isn't me. What the hell kind of thing is this? God. Clickety clickety means rickety tickety. Get your mask on quickety. Some rads, but not that many. I just do not want to suck up a lot. Damn, come on. I've only got another 30 bobby pins.
Got it.
Not really junk, but whatever. Really? Nothing else, just these things? Oh, wait, what do we have back here? Ooh! Guess it wasn't as safe for you as you thought it was gonna be. What the hell is this? That's interesting. Is there any way I can squeeze down there? What is it with this kid? Must be a kid. Tricycle, rubber ball, teddy bear. Not sure how they even got back there. Well, all other things being equal. But it's pretty effective. Once again, not worth the... What the hell? Somebody taking a bath in the back of a truck. Is that? Damn it. Okay. There are mines down here. Good to know. Ghouls themselves? Ah, there's a raider. Get this off. Hmm. took out your turret. What are you gonna do, boyo? Where are you even at?
Come on out. I'll make it nice.
You'll make it what? So, raiders on top of all the rest of it. And more frag mines. Time for a bit of the old mine clearing technique. One bullet, one mine. What else do we have here? Anything else? Well, if I'm gonna be getting in close, I probably want to use something different. Not that, not yet. I'll just switch back over. They've been dealing with quite a few of these boys, haven't they? It's not going to just be one raider either. That'd be a... Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy! Ah! Sometimes running through is not the best option. Did I break anything on that? Nah, I'm just a little tired. Well, Sparkle Cherry will do for that. Admittedly, it's not the best way to clear a tunnel. I should have known better, but here we go. Some band circuit trees survived from that. I'm not seeing where that guy got off to. Was he back here? Rubber. Junk. I wonder if they were doing some kind of reclamation project. You know, scavenging for anything. Multiple sleeping bags, but only one raider so far. That is not right. I should probably figure out how to defuse those mines at some point because I keep running into them. Don't really want to spare schooling. I'm not into that. I'm fishing around in here. Come on. Some aluminum can. Or as somebody I once knew used to call it aluminium. He was quite insistent about that. Let's back out to the main. So that's basically the other side of the pike. Good, meaning that I've cleared one side and all the way back over to here. So they were collecting bones and rubber. That's a very interesting combination. And that's gotta be artificial. They intentionally blocked off this section. sandbags here. So, I wonder what they were up to. It's clearly some kind of fortified checkpoint here. Rather heavily fortified, frankly. You can keep that stupid-looking gas mask, lady. Actually, screw it. Give me that, too. Yeah, you were kind of cute, but you're dead now. And that is all on you. Anything else back this way? Oh, there's another mine. Well, I'm not getting paid for it. So, mine clearing detail is not on the menu today. Anybody hiding over here? No? Okay, good. I can hear somebody sloshing around. Not really what I wanted to do, but okay. There you are. Get your head out of there. Shall roam no more. All that for a silver table knife. Taint worth it. Alright, that's all clear all the way up to there. There's that one little area that I still haven't seen yet. Sounds like somebody's moving around. Yeah, I thought so. Ha-ha. This may be, this is the flip side of that one place that I saw before. Tough one. Halberd, huh? Can't be slavers then. Can't be Western. Can't be volumes because that's the Ellen Halberd. That's basically everything on this side. I know there's more of these. There's always more of them. Eyes are just not focusing. Too wired up on caffeine. Not enough sleep. Alright, that's what I was looking for there.
Sweet.
There we go. Literally the last thing that I picked. Alright. I feel like...
There we go.
Does wear tattoos, but a little itchy on the trigger finger, aren't you, Rory?
Jack, this is Perry. What's taking you so long, cuz? You should have moved more than half this stuff by now. I've got that sanctimonious prick McDonough breathing down my neck. Partner my ass. We gotta get this stuff out of here and skip town before Reese catches on. We'll let his dumb ass take the fall for this and come back in a week or so and say our grandma was having health problems down in New York. Just make sure you're ready tonight. Who's there? You better show yourself, asshole.
And presumably that's when he died. Okay. Let's see if there's anything that I can whip up as long as I'm here. I'd probably use a spare doctor's bag. Just in case. Nothing else really comes to mind. Really don't need the gas mask that much anymore. Pretty weighed down. Should probably call it a night. This looks like it's turning into a real payoff, though. Let me check something here. I'm a little bit overweight. Pointless having so much armor that I can't use. It's really not worth that much. That's what I get for carrying around so much junk. The one guy I knew who would buy this can't. And that's another 4 pounds. gotten everything out of the pike that I can. Interesting that if I'd gone a little further, I would have been into all that. Well, it fulfills the contract, doesn't it? Yeah, I'll call it a celebratory cigar. The pacification of yet another chunk of the Commonwealth. A spark of cola and a smoke. Have a smoke and a smile. Sip that sparkle cola. Do do do. Yeah. The old jingles are still the best.